The Commission on Elections is set to begin the process of hearing the disqualification case filed against presidential candidate Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. The COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez says that the case will be raffled off to one of two divisions of the poll body this week. Summons will also be sent out in the coming days for both sides in relation to the petition against Marcos, which centers on his previous tax conviction. The Marcos camp, however, is brushing off this petition, describing it as a mere nuisance.
So, meron at meron susubok niyan. So, hindi pwedeng sabihin na just because ganyan yung nangyari dati, eh sure na na ganyan ang mangyayari ngayon. Hindi po ganun. Appealable to the Supreme Court.
The One Cebu Party is yet to decide who to endorse for president in the 2022 elections. The head of the party, Cebu's Governor Gwen Garcia, says that they will choose their bet after the deadline of the substitution of candidates lapses on November 15th. She also clarifies that her dinner with presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos and Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio weeks ago does not mean that she is supporting their possible tandem.
I'm not saying that we are not supporting. We have just not come up with a decision yet. There are others who would say I may be naturally sympathetic to former Senator Bongbong Marcos because of the bonds that have already been established. However, my decision does not necessarily reflect the entire party's decision. We need to come together and reach a consensus so that the entire party, One Cebu, will be fully behind the chosen one.
Apart from Marcos, other presidential candidates who met with Garcia in Cebu include Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Domagoso and Senator Panfilo Lacson. The supporters of the 2022 presidential aspirants continue to hold caravans in various parts of the country. In Ilocos Sur, thousands attended Sunday's motorcade backing the candidacy of Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Long lines of red supporters filled some streets in that province as seen in the online videos. Vice President Lenny Robredo supporters also paraded through Bataan with participants adorning their vehicles with pink ribbons. Meanwhile, the supporters of PDP Laban's presidential bet, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa and his vice presidential running mate, Senator Bongo, held a two-day caravan in Metro Manila and in other parts of the country. Now, Sorsogon Governor and senatorial aspirant Francis Chiz Escudero insists that there's nothing wrong with being a guest candidate of different parties. Escudero is currently part of the senatorial tickets of several presidential bets, such as Vice President Lenny Robredo, as well as Senators Panfilo Lacson and Manny Pacquiao. Escudero says that he's even willing to be part of Bongbong Marcos's Senate slate.
I've worked with Senator Marcos. I've worked with people who I don't agree with 100% of the time on all issues. But that does not necessarily make it unlivable for me to be with them or to work with them as well on other issues that we agree on. Sino ba naman ako para magsabi? Let's say a BBM supporter would say, I'm voting for you. Sasabihin, no. Hindi, ayoko yung sinusuporta mong presidente. You would say thank you. And it's not for you to say no to anyone who offers help. But to my mind, Karen, it does not necessarily mean that I have to change any position I will be making. Now, if that is a condition precedent before an adoption would be made, then that's a totally different story.
Personally, however, Escudero says that he's still waiting for the decision of his party, the Nationalist People's Coalition, on who to endorse for president.
I will wait until after the NPC decides, Karen, being a member of the NPC. Now, if they allow us to decide on our own, then we get to decide on our own. If they don't, if they choose someone which I am not personally comfortable with, then perhaps that's the decision of a party member to still remain with the party and not follow.
In other news, Senator Grace Paul urges the Commission on Audit to release its 2020 report on state insurer PhilHealth to give legislators a clearer picture of its finances. In a statement, Paul says that Congress needs to know exactly how much PhilHealth owes hospitals, adding that the government must figure out where to source these funds. She also says PhilHealth cannot resort to delaying and to scare tactics to discourage hospitals from pursuing what's due them. This, as the Audit Commission's 2019 report shows, that benefit claims to PhilHealth are at 75.5 billion pesos. Now, that's nearly double the 39 billion pesos it reported in 2018. In 2020, PhilHealth received 35,000 claims, and only 10,000 of these were paid, amounting to 2.5 billion pesos.